Hello everyone, welcome to the new lecture of Computer Aided Process Synthesis. This is lecture number 19. Topic name is Synthesis of Heat Exchanger Networks. So in last lecture we have seen basics of heat exchanger. I told you that heat exchanger, it is a device designed to efficiently transfer or exchange heat from one matter to another. Means it is a device which is used to exchange heat between the fluids. Okay, and heat exchanger is basically used to minimize the utilities required for synthesis of the heat exchanger network. What is meaning of this? Means there can be heating or cooling utility. I want to minimize those utilities, so I will use heat exchanger device. Means heat exchanger device can be acting as a utility to exchange heat between the hot and cold fluids. So to minimize the utilities, heat exchanger can be used. I will explain this thing in detail in next slide. Next point is, when a fluid is used to transfer heat, the fluid could be liquid such as water or oil, or could be moving air. Means whatever fluids we are going to use in this system, that may be hot water, oil which is acting as a hot steams, or moving air which is also acting as a hot steam. Means we can use here liquid or gaseous phase as a hot stream or liquid stream. There is last point is, most efficient and most important heat exchanger is used in industry, that is shell and tube heat exchanger. This is the most important heat exchanger type which we have seen in last lecture. We have seen there is in heat exchanger, there is a base part is the baffle. Baffle is used to increase the turbulence, or in other words I can say increase the rate of heat transfer. After that there is a front header, there is a rear header. Front header is basically used to enter the process fluid, and rear head is generally used to exit the process fluid. After that there is a tube bundle which is mounted in the shell, and shell is generally used to transfer the hot stream, and tubes are generally used to transfer the cold fluids. This is all about shell and tube heat exchanger which you have seen in last lecture. Now next point about this is the heat exchanger network. What is the meaning of heat exchanger network? It is a heat exchanger network synthesis. You can see here last point. Heat exchanger synthesis means designing a network so that using minimum number of heat exchanger and the use of utilities can be minimized. For better understanding, I am taking one example. Process plant, there is one process plant. Many streams need heating or cooling. Means there are lots of streams which require external heating and cooling. Okay, so utilities like hot air, hot oil or steam are generally used for heating purpose. And utilities like air, water, chilled water, refrigerant generally used for cooling purpose. Means there are lots of streams available in the process plant which require external heating or cooling, okay, to maintain the temperature of the system. So for the heating purpose, hot air, hot oil and steam can be used. But for cooling purpose, chilled water, refrigerant are generally used. But I want to minimize these utilities. Means I want to minimize the utility cost as well. So how to minimize? So you can see here, fourth point, efforts to be made for reducing the use of utilities. Means if I am increasing the utilities, external utilities, so I am increasing the utility cost. I am increasing the operating cost of the process plant. Rather using external utilities, is there any way to use internal heat? So you have to find that, is there any way to use internal heat of the process system? If there is available, you have to use that rather using the external utilities. For example, utility, cooling utility. So there is possibility. What is that? You can see here, fifth point. This can be done by heat integration. So by using heat integration, you can minimize the usage of the external utilities. That may be heating utility or cooling utility. So this is a concept of heat integration. So by using heat integration, you can minimize those costs as well. So what is meaning of this heat integration? it implies heat exchange between the hot and cold streams. It means, you can see here, first point is there is a many streams available in the process plant. That may be hot stream or cold stream. This is the difference between stream and utility. Utilities means we are using externally. Utilities are not part of our actual system. Actual system having the hot stream and cold stream. Streams are available in the process plant, but utilities we are using externally to maintain the temperature of the system. So I'm, what is the meaning of heat integration? It implies heat exchange between the hot stream and cold stream, which is already present in the system. I'm not using utilities, which is externally provided. Means by using heat integration, I'm reducing the use of utilities. At the same time, I am also using the cost of utility, external utilities. However, this increases the number of heat exchanger. But how these hot stream and cold stream, which are already present in the system, are exchanging the heats in between the fluids? That can be possible by using heat exchanger. I told you meaning of heat exchanger, that heat exchanger can be used to exchange heat between cold and hot fluid. Means by using heat exchanger, I can do this heat integration. Heat integration is possible by using heat exchanger. Means we are minimizing the heat utilities, but at the same time I'm increasing the heat exchanger. Okay, I'm increasing the heat exchanger and I'm minimizing the heat utilities, external utilities. Okay, so however this increase the heat number of heat exchanger. So I want to avoid this as well. Means I want to avoid the increasing in the heat exchanger. So how that can be possible? You can see last point, heat exchanger synthesis. This can be possible by using heat exchanger synthesis. What is the meaning of this? It means designing a network such that it using the minimum number of heat exchangers and the using the minimum number of utilities. Means it also minimizes the utilities as well as number of usage of the heat exchangers. Means heat synthesis, heat exchanger synthesis means I'm also minimizing the heat utilities and at the same time I'm also minimizing the heat exchanger requirement. This concept is known as heat exchanger synthesis, or I can say heat exchanger network synthesis, where I'm minimizing the heat utilities, external utilities, I'm using heat exchanger, but by using it, heat network synthesis, I'm also minimizing the heat exchanger requirement. So this concept is known as heat exchanger network synthesis. So this can be possible using one technique that known as pinch technique. We'll see this technique in detail in next lecture, in coming lecture. So this technique can be used to design this heat exchanger network synthesis. Now next point is how to represent heat exchanger network. How to represent? You can see here there are multiple circles are there. These circles are nothing but heat exchangers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 8, 12 plus 3, 15. These 15 are the heat exchangers available in this diagram. You can see here H1, H2, H3, C1, C2, C3 are the process streams. These are not utilities. These are the process streams which is already exist in the process plant. So there are three heat utility, heat process streams and three cold streams. Okay, and I am not using here any type of utility, or I can use here utilities but in minimum number. Why I am using here in minimum number? Because I am having here lots of heat exchanger. You can see here heat exchanger are acting as nothing but one such a type of device which is exchanging heat between the cold and hot stream by minimizing the number of usage of the utilities. Okay, so what is the rule for that? You can see here minimum number of heat exchanger requirement. This is rule for the heat exchanger synthesis. Last point you can see here, heat exchanger synthesis. So this is a rule for heat exchanger synthesis, where I am minimizing the number of heat exchanger requirement. The formula for that, that is U minimum is equal to capital N minus 1. What is the capital N? Capital N is nothing but number of process streams, that is hot stream plus cold streams. Okay, number of process streams, that is nothing but N1 plus number of utilities. External utilities, that may be heating or cooling. So capital N is, it is the summation of number of process streams plus number of utilities. Capital N1 plus capital N2. This is nothing but capital N, and capital N is the process stream plus utility. And how to use that, this capital N, to find number of minimum heat exchanger? That is by using U minimum is equal to capital N minus 1. So for 3 marks question can be possible in your exam. Okay, number of streams, a number of process streams can be given, and number of utilities can be given, and you have to find here minimum number of heat exchanger. So this is formula for that, capital N minus 1, and you can see here capital N is process streams plus utilities. So what we have seen in today's lecture, we have seen meaning of heat exchanger, we have revised this concept in this lecture. After that, we have considered one process plant where we have considered lots of process streams, hot streams and cold streams, and we have used here utilities as well, that may be heating utilities or cooling utilities. And after that, we have seen concept of heat integration, where we are minimizing the number of utilities but we are adding the heat exchanger. After that, we have seen heat exchanger synthesis concept, where we are minimizing heat exchanger as well as we are minimizing number of utilities. Okay, there can be one question like this possible in your exam. Explain in detail meaning of heat exchanger network synthesis or heat exchanger synthesis for 7 marks. So you have to write like this. You have to consider one process plant, you have to write all these points. After that, you have to mention the technique, that is a pinch technique, which we are going to see in coming lectures. After that, you have to write here representation of heat exchanger network. You have to write this point as well for 7 mark concept. Okay, so for 7 marks question, you have to write all these three slides in your exam. And you have to also write definition for heat exchanger device. So this is all about this lecture. Thank you.